Hey everyone, let's talk about what numerical and analytical methods are, their applications, and the key differences between numerical and analytical methods. Numerical methods are powerful mathematical tools that enable us to solve numerical problems. But what exactly does that mean? Essentially, these methods allow us to find approximate solutions to math problems. By employing clever mathematical techniques, we can get incredibly close to the exact answer. Let's spend some time and talk about analytical methods. Analytical methods involve employing a set of logical steps that are proven to find an exact solution to a given problem. For example, if we have an equation like x plus 1 equals 0, we can easily determine the exact value of x by subtracting 1 from both sides. Similarly, analytical methods work effectively for other mathematical operations, such as derivatives, integrals, and all the other math concepts that you've likely learned in school so far. However, what if finding the exact solution to a math problem takes an enormous amount of time and effort, or worse, it's not even possible to find one? Well, this is where numerical methods shine. Numerical methods consist of mathematical formulas and techniques that allow us to approximate and get close enough to the analytical or real solution. In exchange for sacrificing a bit of that accuracy, we gain the advantage of faster and often much simpler results. Now, let's explore an extremely simple example of how this works in practice. Let's look at the earlier equation, x plus 1 equals 0. Quickly, let's define a small procedure for how we can approximate the answer to this problem numerically. Let's begin with some arbitrary guess to our answer. Then solve the equation, check our error, adjust our guess, and repeat. This is a very simple numerical approximation algorithm. Let's begin with a guess of minus 0.5 and evaluate how close we are to our exact answer. Well, as we can see, we are off by 0.5. Now, we could add or subtract a step size here, and it'll be 50-50 on which direction our solution lies in. A step size is just going to be the change in our x direction to see what our output is. Guessing our solution is to the right of minus 0.5, let's try that. Well, nope, that didn't work. Our error got bigger, as you can see, meaning that we moved away from our solution. Therefore, we could go back to minus 0.5 and move in the other direction. And as you can see, this allows us to move closer and closer to our exact answer through approximations. Now, obviously this is an extremely trivial example, but it shows you how we can get close to an answer without the common analytical mathematical techniques that you've learned so far. Much of numerical methods is about reducing the error of our approximations, and commonly this is a trade-off between computational speed, how fast we get our answer, versus the error we receive, how far off we are the exact answer. Numerical methods are incredible mathematical tools that allow us to find derivatives, integrals, root finding, just like we would analytically. But they can also enable us to approximate continuous functions from discrete data sets through interpolation. They can also help us solve ordinary impartial differential equations, and much more, which we will learn throughout this course. Numerical methods are being used every day in just about every branch of STEM, and it's an extremely useful topic that will help you solve an incredible number of future problems. Throughout this course, you'll witness how numerical methods and computers work hand in hand, significantly simplifying our lives and expanding the realm of what we can actually achieve with math. I hope that this video helped your understanding of what numerical methods are, and the difference between them and analytical methods. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.